Welcome to Pharmacology by Lecturio. I'm Dr. Praveen Shukla. We're going to be covering some reproductive pharmacology today. Listen, this is a huge topic. You can see all the different subtypes and categories on the screen beside me. The gonadal hormone antagonists and agonists sometimes do the same thing, and sometimes they do the opposite thing of what you expect. We're going to spend a lot of time in each section, and we're going to go over them in detail so that you understand them and you feel confident answering questions on exams. We're going to be talking about estrogens and anti-estrogens. We'll be talking about progestins and anti-progestins, and we're going to be talking about androgens and anti-androgens. With respect to the anti-estrogen medications, there's a whole bunch of subtypes there. There are the receptor antagonists, there are aromatase inhibitors, and then there are GnRH agonists like danazol and antagonists, which interestingly enough do the same thing. Underneath the receptor antagonist section, estrogen receptor antagonists, we have full antagonists and we have selective antagonists. With respect to the progestins, we have actual progestin that we administer, and we have an antiprogestin called miviprostone. With respect to the androgens, we have a whole list of medications. We have antiandrogens that are receptor antagonists. We have 5-alpha reductase inhibitors. We have synthesis inhibitors. And we have other ones, such as the GnRH agonists and antagonists. When we take a look at reproductive pharmacology, just have a look at this diagram. I won't go over it in detail now because each section of this diagram will be placed beside the specific area that we're talking about. This just gives us an overview. So have a look at it on your own time. It's a very good diagram to understand how all of the drugs fit in.